the aha moment. It's that split second when you realize you've discovered something new. For researchers looking to find new treatments and cures for diseases, it's the ultimate goal. There have been a lot of big aha moments at the University of Minnesota. The first external pacemaker, the first successful bone marrow transplant, and the world's first stem cell institute. But the University of Minnesota is not content to look back at past achievements. Our focus is on the future, finding the treatments and cures that improve the health of all Minnesotans.
It's all about the faculty. It's really the faculty who are doing research that have this desire for discovery and innovation and taking that knowledge and using it to prevent and treat disease. That's really what health sciences is about.
To keep moving our research forward, the big questions we've been asking are, how do we maximize our ability to discover? What new resources are needed? Is it possible to accelerate the process? Our answer is the Biomedical Discovery District.
It's a place to bring people together around research. So in the design of the laboratories, the design of the facilities, it's important that they are able to see each other, talk to each other, cross disciplines, and that's where the real innovation seems to come from.
Before we dive deeper into what the Biomedical Discovery District will do, let's define what it is. The Biomedical Discovery District is a cluster of buildings just north of the new TCF Bank Stadium on the university's East Bank. Nearly 400,000 square feet of research space for an additional 40 principal investigators will be built by 2014. There will be meeting rooms, a cafe, and common areas for researchers to meet and mix. Future expansion plans would add more labs and buildings to house private sector partners. But this isn't just about building more space. The true power is how that space will be used.
The days are gone, I think, of the individual investigator in their own laboratory who can really make major accomplishments applying just one set of techniques that come from one discipline.
An integrated approach is key to the design of the Biomedical Discovery District. For example, space will be designed for memory research, or infectious disease research, or cell therapies, all coming together to give researchers the right kind of tools needed to be innovative and make discovery happen. This approach allows the Biomedical Discovery District to be a place for big goals.
The goal of my research is to cure diabetes, and we are collaborating with scientists who are already transplanting human and ultimately stem cell-derived islets that produce insulin for curing diabetes.
FERPO is closing in on a cure, and the Biomedical Discovery District will help her keep moving forward.
One, it brings more resources and more laboratories and more physical tools for us to be able to do our work, and also bring scientists from other disciplines, important disciplines for diabetes research like immunology and biochemistry, who all can give us insights to do the work that we have to do.
Another big goal for the Biomedical Discovery District, unravel the mysteries of Alzheimer's disease.
The main goal of our research is to understand how Alzheimer's is initiated and then to target those molecular pathways so that we can prevent the disease. And we're now even beginning to understand how to lower their levels using compounds that are so safe that you don't even need a doctor's prescription to obtain them. But there's only so much a single researcher can do. We really need a critical mass to come together and put our heads together, put our different expertise together, and figure out what is the best path towards developing guidelines to prevent Alzheimer's disease.
Construction is currently underway in the Biomedical Discovery District to expand the Center for Magnetic Resonance Research. This new space will house several new magnets, including the world's largest human imaging magnet, a powerful tool that will be used by researchers from many specialties. And meetings are also underway on the next phase of expansion. Construction should begin in 2011. The state legislature approved $292 million in bonding authority for these buildings in 2008. Support from the state is vital, but philanthropy is also important. The university is seeking $73 million in contributions.
We can't take this innovation and make it a reality in the care system unless we have the companies that are going to develop it, produce it, market it. And when this district was conceived, it became very clear that the innovation that's required to keep Minnesota from becoming a flyover state in the biosciences is really to make a major investment in the engine of innovation, and that's us.
So that's the promise: more cures, faster. We've shared the basics, but there is much more going on in the Biomedical Discovery District. To learn more, go to bdd.umn.edu.